Hi folks, my name is David Pegler. I'm the pre-learner coach at FX Bootcamp. This is a quick review of what we covered in the pre-learning session in today's training, August the 22nd. Let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is simply education. We're not an alert service, and we're not going to give any trade recommendations during the course of a day, but what we do is conduct some fundamental tactical analysis and hopefully put together some successful trade plans for the day. Remember that trading is always risky business, and you should not trade real money until you have a proven track record of success. Well, I just want to talk about a little Kiwi USD trade. We don't profile this pair a ton in the videos, but it is a very, very tradable, very technically traded currency pair, and I personally spend a lot of time in it. Well, today, when we were looking at pre-London, we had a question from a member pertaining to working out which time frame is necessarily in control from day to day, because we can see that sometimes it seems like price has been governed by the 15-minute, other times it seems like it's been governed by other time frames. So the question is, how do you determine which time frame is most important? Sorry for the delay and update there. What you're looking at here is a daily chart of the New Zealand dollar. Now, what you'll notice in Bootcamp is that we talk a lot about speed of the market, okay? And I don't think anybody's bullish on the Kiwi dollar at the moment, but you're gonna have retracements even in a bear market. Okay, but what you can see definitely is what we like to call angle and separation between the 21:55 EMAs here, and that gives you a measure of speed in the market. All right, anytime you have an EMA that's pointing down sharply in a pair like this one, there's no secret here that New Zealand's been in a downtrend for for some time now, and we're definitely looking for continuation of that trend. Whether that's going to be in the next few days or not, well, that's still to be determined. But the bottom line is, anytime you have an EMA, particularly the 21 EMA that has not been tested and has good angle and separation like this 21 does on the daily chart, you're likely to find it getting given some level of respect. Okay, well, intraday, that's going to mean a trading opportunity for us. Okay, so it might only be a single day's worth of respect for the 21 EMA, and what I mean by respect is a bounce off of it. Again, whether it might just be a single day's worth of respect of the 21 before making higher highs, we'll find that out next week. But for today, we absolutely expected a 21 EMA that had not been tested for us to see a bounce there. Okay, but if we relate that back to an hourly chart when pre-London started, okay, what we noticed here was an uptrend in itself. Okay, so the hourly chart wasn't gonna give up that easy, now was it? The 21 EMA on the hourly pushed through over here on the chart, and effectively you were bouncing off the 21 on the hourly as well. I mean, we noticed that we've been in a steady uptrend, whether that's just just some short covering and a bear market rally, so to speak. Well, the bottom line is that we were still going to see bounces off the shorter term charts, okay? And if we go to a 15-minute, if we go to a 15-minute chart here, one of two things was going to play out. So we had a level of logic in that the daily was going to play a role for us, but we still had to see the hourly and 15-minute charts wash out for the day, etc. Okay, what I mean by wash out is that they had to, the 15-minute and the hourly, etc., had to be given their due respect. So in a quick moving uptrend on the hourly, you are likely to see a bounce there before the daily was given that respect. Remember that the smaller time frames are seen as self-similar building blocks for the longer term time frames. Okay, so what we effectively saw was one of two scenarios. Okay, we were either going to bounce off that hourly 21, all right, and head up to the next level of resistance, which was about 72.22. Alternatively, we were going to bounce off that 21 on the hourly and come up and make a logical fib pointing to the downside and then roll to the downside. Well, the question then was, how do we know if we're going to fib there or if we're going to go up and hit that resistance before coming down? Okay, and it's quite simple. There was no guesswork required, yeah? Okay, when you pull the fib pointing to the downside, okay, we absolutely identified this level as a possible bounce point. In fact, you see my little alarm, you see my little alarm here that I had way before price ever got there. Okay, and the methodology was really simple here. All right, take a bounce off the hourly 21 to the upside because you're still in an uptrend. You still want to capture those pips to the long side. However, if when you get to the fib and the alarm is triggered, if you then get a 1 minute MACD to the downside, you surrender the long and go short, giving that daily 21 the respect that that you're looking for on it. Okay, we expected a bounce of the daily 21. Just trying to time that on a 15-minute chart is challenging. So we identified a few possible scenarios, and then when price got to the fib, it was just a matter of pulling up the 1 minute chart, and you got a 1 minute MACD cross right at excuse me, you got a 1 minute MACD cross right at the fib, and price subsequently dropped. So there was no guesswork. It was just a case of identifying, just a case of identifying the fib when it got there, watching your short-term confirmation chart in the way of a 1 minute, and down she rolled. But it was more a, you know, the trade aside, support and resistance, fibs aside, it was more a measure of working out which currency or which date, which time frame was in charge here. And today it was the daily chart. However, we needed to relate it back to an hourly and a 15-minute, and this is one time that it worked out beautifully, just as we planned. And it was nice to see it happen because we had planned it out strategically well ahead of time, and each different time frame was given its what's given it you know each different time frame was given its own level of respect, and price subsequently came down off that daily 21. Anyway, I hope this video was somewhat helpful to you. I hope to see you in class sometime. This concludes your pre-London review from August the 22nd. Have a good day further.